Greetings and welcome. Today's video will be completely about the construction of my new bicycle car, number 14, from last year. I already showed the first test drive with it, but nothing about the work I had to put into this thing. Here is one of the two bicycles I took apart, because there was a need for two similar head tubes. That pivot is from my old wheelchair, where he is used to mount one of the wheels. Because I wanted to use those wheels, I needed that pivot as well. The problem was that I had to find a new socket, because the original one from the wheelchair was made out of some metal which wasn't magnetic, so no steel, which meant I couldn't weld it. Luckily, I could found a water tube which was fitting just fine. Now I was able to mount my two wheelchair wheels to my two bicycle head tubes. Also, I did some maintenance to the head tube bearings, cleaned the parts with brake cleaner and added some new grease with a knife. My goal was to make the new vehicle a little bit narrower than the old one. Here I am determining the new wideness of my new front axle. Then there was that kind of session in which I tried to figure out whether I should use leaf springs for suspension purposes or not. Next, I did a shopping tour, because I was need for a proper car seat for my new vehicle. Otherwise, I couldn't determine the wideness of my frame that I wanted to build. Therefore, I visited a scrapyard. That's the seat I've chosen, but there was still a problem. The seat surface was just too long, so I had to change that. Thanks to the adjustable calf cushion, it wasn't a big deal to shorten it at all. After I was finished with the cutting and welding, I had to do some stitching. For that I used a sewing awl. After some days, I was finished with the seat. I even removed all unnecessary parts, because that seat was still very heavy, and he needed to be as light as possible. Finally, I was able to continue with the frame. Just spot welded everything, in case I have to take it apart eventually. The highlight of the day. Me, the first time sitting in my new car. I did some little progress, till I needed again some bicycle parts, this time a proper bottom bracket. With the new bottom bracket in place, I continued my work on the frame. Had to lift the front part of the frame, because my front axle needed some space. Here I am mounting some stabilizers onto my front axle. I bolt those out of some car coupling rods. And the front axle is finally mounted. As you can see, I chose simple car springs instead of leaf springs. Again, some right reducing of the seat, because he is still very heavy. Now I had to mount that single rear wheel. This time I wanted to build my own rear suspension pivot, because the original ones for mountain bikes are just too weak to endure the forces which are coming from the side. That's why I built my own rubber band bearings. Here I am cutting rubber band bits with my sheet metal chisel. Sadly, I didn't have the lathe back then to enlarge those measures, so I had to do it manually. After I mounted my new rear suspension pivot system, I installed the rear shock. Here I am checking if the angle of the frame part is suitable or not. Needed two curved angle irons to construct the upper part of my future engine hood. Used my self-made metal bender for that. Till this very moment I spot welded just everything, so it isn't a problem to bend the frame till everything fits just like it's supposed to do. Just connecting two angle irons using a third angle iron to guide the other ones. Here the most crucial part, mounting those steering arms while adjusting the right angle, because I tried to use that Ackermann principle once more. Also, I had to ensure that there was enough space between the pedal and the handlebar beneath it. Then it was the time to turn around the whole thing and do some welding from the bottom side as well. I attached an additional brace onto my stabilizers, because otherwise it wouldn't endure the side forces properly. After some more welding, the whole vehicle frame was finally rigid. Here I mounted the rear suspension with the wheel. I even installed an additional iron pipe to drive the forces, which will occur there, directly to the rest of the frame. Yep, that looks quite good.
Not bad.
Mounting the bottom bracket, which will function as some kind of pulley. Adjusting the bearing. It needs to spin freely but isn't allowed to wobble. On that bearing I wanted to mount a little chain ring with very big side washers to keep the chain on track. Therefore I had to build myself such a custom part. I made those washers out of that thick aluminum sheet. Notice those black markings on the metal. If I'm not wrong, that piece is actually from the Second World War. I think it was some target destination device. What gives? Just needed some thick aluminum, and this one is even great looking and got a history. Finally, I was able to mount that pulley. With it, I had problems, because there wasn't enough clearance for the bolt heads. Had to do some filing. Had still to attach a washer and a split pin onto my self-made rubber bearings from the rear axle suspension unit to secure it properly. The steering system was a challenge as well. The steering rod, for example, couldn't be rigid because the front axle is moving in the two dimensions. Always use aluminum as chisel while hammering on some precision steel parts to avoid deformation. My first attempt to build it wouldn't work at all. Those bowden cables were just a stupid idea. My second attempt just worked fine. I took the design from my pedal car that I had once in my childhood. Next, I installed aluminum sheet floor because I still needed to attach some chain guide tubes. For those chain guide tubes, I used electric plastic cable pipes out of the hardware store. I noticed just in time that the rear derailleur was completely worn out. Just look. Well, that one is better. Next, I had to mount the front derailleur a little bit lower, so that the chain isn't rubbing in the lowest gear. The chain drive system was working and I continued on the bodywork, but there was a new problem. The aluminum sheet which I was using was terribly bended. To make it smooth, I needed a new tool, an English wheel. Well, as you can see, I made it myself, with the help of my new lathe, which I bought recently, because otherwise I couldn't have manufactured those bearing fittings onto that big metal wheel of the English wheel. Here I am bowling a door with a wooden plate as frame and a piece of aluminum sheet as covering. I even constructed my own door lock. I wanted to make the front grille out of some aluminum hole sheet, but just the sheet metal wasn't rigid enough. It was wobbling a lot, so I decided to strengthen it with beds. Therefore, I needed a 12 bed roller machine. Well, this time I spent some money and bought a cheap one. And it's finally finished. My 14th vehicle, which is a direct successor of my bicycle vehicle 8 from 2016. That's it. Goodbye and have a nice day today. Why my aluminum sheet was bent that terrible in the first place, you're asking? Well, originally it was corrugated iron from a roof, that's why. Beep! Well, recently I forked about rebuilding my 8th vehicle, because that one from 2016 is by far the best one. No other of my following vehicles could beat it. It's just pretty comfy and pleasant to drive. Almost everything is perfect, but not everything. So let's do it again with that collected knowledge and make it even better. Beep!